As news announcements,
please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good Friday morning, Redskins. Welcome to a fantastic Friday. Here with a live audience, half that are paying attention and half that aren't. Here's the news you need to know for today, Friday, October 2nd. First of all, congratulations to our Lady Redskins soccer team on their big win last night against Fulton. Had lots of students in attendance last night to see the ladies totally dominate the Lady Falcons last night. We are proud of you, ladies. Tonight is a big night as the 6-0 Redskin football team travels to Englewood for a big district contest against McMinn Central. Tickets will be sold at the gate, so if you did not pre-buy the tickets earlier in the week, you can now buy them there. Good luck to our Redskins. Sometimes we think about... as we head into this cooler weather, many of our Many of you have registered false high temperatures this morning as you arrived when we're taking your temperature. Most of those were those that were dropped off. If possible, we want you to turn your heat down in your car a few minutes prior to arriving. This will keep you from having to stand in the cold while your body cools, and for the person dropping you off to not have to sit there until your temperature comes down to normal. Now, on the things that we do for this idiotic virus, I know. You know what, though? As usual, guys, our attitude determines how we handle things. The more you count your blessings, the less we'll be stressing. Expect success today. The more we focus on it, the more we'll find it. Let's take care of business on this Friday, on this beautiful Friday, Redskins. We will, and we hope you will join us. Now, on to bigger and better things. This is the premiere of The Best Thing for Me with Kaleb, Kelsay, and Hunter DeLand, a music video project that Mrs. Peterson's digital art class has been working on for many weeks. How many weeks you guys been working on this?
Well, probably like four or five by now, yeah.
It's really an amazing undertaking. I saw kind of a pre-showing of it, and I'm super excited to see it. So let's get on to bigger and better things. Let me get off the set here. I'm going to let you guys take over, and let's get this thing going on.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, so thank you, Mr. Mack. Before we get the live show completely started and get going, we have a special guest coming here today to give us announcements, Miss Michelle. She is on her way over. Okay, so welcome to our show, our lovely Miss Michelle, the lunch lady. Crazy lunch lady, is that what we're going with?
Maybe.
Here, pull that
cafeteria
mic down
manager.
For us. Cafeteria manager. Okay, and she's got a special announcement for us.
I just want to let everybody know and remind you that everyone eats free in the cafeteria until December 31st. Come down and join us. After fall break, we will be doing Smart Mouth Pizza every day as a daily choice. So come down and eat with us.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And yes, everybody come get food. That's a big help. Okay, so before we get started, before we get Kaleb and Hunter out here, I think we're going to talk about some things. Elijah, you are in charge of the next episode of the Landon Elijah Show. Can you tell us what's going on next week?
Yes, I am. All I can say is that class 5, but tune in because we're going to have a special guest. It's going to be Dr. Stafford, and tune in to see what we're going to be talking about. You're going to love it. You have something you're not going to want to miss, so just tune into that.
Can you give us like just a tad bit of what you're going to be talking about?
Well, all I can tell you is that we're going to be talking about the bug out bag, some more stuff like that, and more survival-based stuff with some things about the ecosystem, but that's all I can tell you. I can't tell you no more than that
okay.
Right there.
We wouldn't want to spoil any
secrets. Spoil that right there.
So, what do you guys want to talk about first?
We can talk about the mindset that it takes to just to be able to come out here and do this. You know, a lot of people think that this might be easy, but no, it's not easy. You know, we just come out here and do this thing. And
are you talking about all the crazy people in the background right now?
Yeah, I'm talking about all the crazy people in the background and how much prepping we have to do this. A lot of people don't understand, and I'm just glad that about the friendships that we built doing this. You know, a lot of people don't understand, but You know, okay. I'm definitely come a long way.
And today is a football night, right?
Today is a football
night. We do have to talk about football a little bit.
Yeah.
So do you know who we're playing tonight?
Oh, we're playing McMinn, right?
Yes. Right. Okay, so we're going to get a score prediction from everybody. Elijah, can I get a score prediction?
I think we could get them 44-0, maybe.
44-0?
44-0.
Okay. Zoe?
I have no clue. I don't watch football.
Give
so
me a guess.
I have no
Stop
clue.
Stop being boring. Just guess.
I have no clue.
I don't care.
I don't
say
watch
something.
Football,
so oh my God, say something. Pick a number.
54.
54-0?
Yeah, sure.
I'm going to go 57-7. I think that's a solid guess.
And not only that, you know, it takes a lot of dedication to be on the team, too. All I know is that we got it tonight, and, you know, it's going to be a good game. So try to attend that as well.
The cheerleaders wanted me to say that it's vitally important for them to be there. They wanted a shout-out.
Is it true that it's pink out night?
It is.
It is
Wait,
pink
is
out.
It pink out? No, that was soccer last
no,
night,
No, that was
I think.
Soccer night.
Yeah. Soccer okay. Last night. Zoe, you play soccer. How'd that go last night?
Good.
Did?
Big 6-0 win.
6-0 win?
Yeah. 6-0 win.
Do you know who had the most goals?
Kenya.
Of course.
She had five, and five. Then Angel Baker got one.
Come on, no goals? You're
I
letting down.
Defense.
You're
what let. Do
I don't care. You're letting down the team, honestly. Honestly. Elijah? How's your week been?
My week's been fairly busy. All I have to say is it's been a good week. Every day is a good day. Every day above ground is a good day. And I know it's not always the best day and stuff like that, but you can make every day the best day. And just remember to hold all those, your loved ones and friends close to you because they won't always be there for you, you know. Not on the depressing stuff, but, you know, and so forth. But we got some Mario Kart live action stuff happening the 8th. And
yes, tune in, watch that. I mean, I know for a fact that I could take both of you two at Mario Kart.
No. I could.
That's not even a question.
No.
I am.
No, sir. Okay,
I am a different breed. I'm a different
that
breed.
That needs to be one of our broadcasts.
You couldn't beat me.
I bet I could.
Elijah, do you play Mario Kart?
No, I used to. I used to play Mario, just the regular
on
game.
What?
And
on the Wii?
On the Wii, yes.
I love the Wii. Yeah, the Wii was the best. You play Wii Sports?
It's so well. Yes. I used to play Wii Sports, but people don't understand about the Wii. It's such an underrated console. Like
it really
true.
Is.
You know, it's,
you know, Call of Duty came out on the Wii.
Did it for real?
Yes, Call of
did
Duty
it?
Came
oh,
out
my gosh,
on the Wii.
Awesome.
I had no idea.
Yeah, it was hard to play, but. No, I used to play Wii Sports all the time. I was a beast at Wii Sports.
Wii Sports?
Yeah, or Wii Resort. That was fun, too.
Wii Resort was my game.
The lightsaber fighting?
The lightsaber fight. Oh, you mean, the boxing for me is where it was at.
The boxing was fun, too.
Yeah, it was like,
I mean, I think I could take you.
You know, just, you know.
So I was told to let you guys know that the chat is open for questions or whatever
comment
you guys
want to
put in it or score predictions for the football game or whatever. The chat is open, and we are monitoring that.
Yeah. Let's try to keep it PG, all right? No nastiness.
That's true.
Okay, Elijah, you are known for your motivation. That is what you are known for, okay? So I want you to give everybody, while we're waiting to get Kaleb and Hunter on here, I want you to give everyone the best piece of advice or best piece of motivation you can give them.
Make every day your best day. And like I said before, it's never about where you're from. It's always about where you're going. So, you know, it's never about how you start the race. It's always about how you finish. It's a marathon. You know, keep pushing. That's what Nipsey Hussle said, you know. Just all the way through the finish, you know. And for us seniors, it's our last lap. So we're trying to finish hard. And, you know, we got many more races to run. I'm not saying this is our last race, but this is our final lap here at the high school. And we're trying to finish strong. And we hope you guys will finish strong as well. Any motivation from you guys as well?
No, I think that pretty much covered it. I mean, Elijah, that's your job. I make the jokes. You make it serious. That's the dynamic duo here. I think, we're going to wait for Kaleb to finish eating. And then we're going to pull him up here and talk to him about the song. But just to recap, we will be releasing his song at 12. And then shortly after, I'm not exactly sure the times, it will be released on iTunes. Where else? Spotify,
YouTube,
SoundCloud, YouTube. It'll all be up. The music video will be on YouTube. I think they're all at Kaleb Kelsay. I think okay. Is that my right?
That's more chats.
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
Okay. Elijah, you're Pog.
Pog.
Elijah, you're Pog. I don't know what that means, but that's what they said.
And then
Elijah.
Someone said that they love you.
Oh, yeah, I love them too. Keep being good.
I think everyone loves you, Elijah. That's why you get – what did you get most friendly? You got friendliest, right?
Friendliest, yeah.
And then I don't know how me and Zoe got most creative. I can't draw a stick figure right.
But it's not just based on drawing.
I am not creative. I am not.
So I don't
but
know.
Hey, whatever.
Well, it
know.
Doesn't have
we'll
to be always art related for creativity.
Well, it's most
like you, your
yeah,
joke
is
most artistic.
That's like literally the title of
that,
it. But you got friendliest.
Friendliest.
Why do you think
that.
You got friendliest, Elijah?
I'm an all around guy. I mean, I don't, you know.
Don't mean to brag or anything.
I don't mean to brag. But I have my days like anyone else. But there really is no reason to be mean to anyone, like at all. You know, it's just. Be nice, and I know even though you don't feel like smiling, you should smile anyway. It's a contagious thing, so you know.
Like yawning?
Yeah, like yawning. You know, if you smile at someone in the hallway, you're likely to get a smile back, and that's just what we want to spread around here, you know. It's really good.
Positivity.
Positivity.
I don't know how you're so positive, Elijah, but it is contagious.
Yeah.
It really is. Being in a classroom with you is something else.
I know. We built awesome relationships, you know. I never thought I'd, you know, make friends. You know what I mean? I've always seen myself as kind of like that lone wolf guy. But being in the class and being on a team, it'll really change you a lot in a good way, you know, and to learn to work with people and build leadership skills and stuff like that.
Elijah, someone in the chat wants to know, do we play Among Us?
Among Us. I've heard a lot of talk about that.
I haven't
and,
played it.
It looks like off the set here, some of us are agreeing that, you know, they do play Among Us. Me. Personally, I haven't played that game yet, but, you know, I do play PUBG Mobile, so you can check me out on there.
Next week in class, are we just going to skip the news station and play Among Us?
Yep. Let's do it.
Well, if that's what y'all want to do, we can, okay. I mean, we'll have
I'm
to deal with the gaming club.
That was
that,
Elijah's
but.
Idea if we get in trouble. Elijah, so this weekend, was it this week? No, this week, a couple days ago, you sent us a picture of a snake you caught. I wanted to know more about it. What was going on there?
The snake is a black rat snake. They're the constrictors of North America. They can get up to 6 foot long.
Pretty. How long was he?
Well, he was just about this long. He was a little guy. He was outside. He was fighting for his life. My dogs had him in the corner, but I saved his life. And, you know.
I bet your dogs are upset.
Well, they really, you know, how it is with snakes. See, now with them being a constrictor, he doesn't have any venom, so. The best thing for him to do is to mimic a deadly snake. So he's rattling his tail. He's standing up, you know, and he's striking, and they're backing up, and, you know.
I killed a snake this weekend.
Oh, what? That is.
That's
he was
that's
all up next to my garage. And see, but the thing is we get snakes that, like, crawl up in our garage, right?
Mm.
And my mother, when she goes out at 4 in the morning to go to work, will wake me up and tell me to go kill the snake that's in the garage next to her car. And so I don't want to do that. So when I see they get close, I take care of business.
Well, it's not just about taking care of business. People don't understand how easy it is to defuse the situation. See, all you need is like a stick, something like that. Point the head. It's a technique is called tailing. So you just take the stick and you point the snake's head. And if you can grab it by the tail, you just, you know, kind of control it, keep its head away from you, you know.
Some of us don't like to touch things that bite or play with snakes. Some of us aren't animal like friendly like that, you know. Things that could bite me, no, they can go back to where they came from.
Really awesome.
So including dogs.
Okay, but dogs can get kicked in the face. I'm joking, I love dogs.
That's animal
cruelty.
Gosh.
I would never do
what
that.
What is your favorite breed of dog? Like, what do you like?
German Shepherd.
Zoe,
beautiful dogs.
I don't know, because I've like had so many that it's like,
what's your favorite? Ben,
I have no clue.
What do you think the prettiest breed of dog
the
is?
The prettiest breed? I don't know.
Oh, my.
It has to be
anything.
The pit bull by far. The
Dude,
pit bull.
Dude, pit bulls, yes. Okay,
German
and
Shepherd,
yep. One thing I have to say is it's Ilse's birthday.
Happy birthday.
She
happy
asked
birthday.
For us to talk to you guys and say to vote, to register to vote. If
yes,
you're
everybody register to vote. Go to Miss Brewster's.
Vote is very important.
She will get you all set up. And happy birthday, Ilse.
Yeah.
Live it up. Ask her how, is she 18? Is she 18 now?
I think. Camden Trip says cancel Mallow 2020.
Okay. What are we canceling?
Just you.
Just me? Do I need to leave?
Is no, that, don't leave, bro. Don't leave.
Are we canceling me?
Don't
dang
listen
it,
to them.
That's not nice. Who else we got in the chat? Someone said they I don't know who that is.
They
who
like
is
my shirt.
Who's Gary Squarepants?
Yeah. I don't know.
Are you from SpongeBob? That's fun. Elijah, Okay, on the note of cartoons, I want to talk about this because you're a very interesting person.
You think so?
What's your favorite cartoon?
Was it Chowder off of Boomerang? Was that Boomerang Chowder?
Chowder is good.
Was it Courage the Cowardly Dog of the Flintstones, the Jetsons?
The Flintstones were good. It was good. That was a good show.
What about you personally? Did anyone watch Nickelodeon, anything like that?
What cartoons did I watch? I was more of like a Disney XD kind of person when I was a kid.
Dude,
like,
SpongeBob all the way.
I didn't watch a lot of SpongeBob.
SpongeBob all the way.
I'm trying to think. What kind of cartoons? Like Ben 10?
Ben 10, yeah. That's like
Ben 10
smacked. OG cartoon, could say.
Yeah, I mean, that was an older one. The newer ones sucked.
Was that Fairly Odd Parents?
Pokemon.
I like that.
Fairly Odd Parents was good. No. Pokemon, yeah. When we were little kids.
Well, when I was little, we had DirecTV, and a certain time after dark, we had something called Adult Swim. There was all types of stuff on there, like Family Guy, stuff that I shouldn't have been watching, but hey, I watched it anyway.
Yeah, we're just here to tell you. Elijah's just informing you because he knows, but he's not telling you to watch that.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying that it had some really good anime stuff on there. And speaking of cartoons, anime is okay. And
you like anime?
Yeah, anime.
I haven't gotten
really
into anime. Unless you count, like, the Avatar as anime.
Well, you got Dragon Balls,
like
Naruto, some other stuff like that.
No, I was never into that.
Yeah.
Have you watched Avatar, The Last Airbender?
Oh, yeah.
I love that
show.
That is a good show.
They come out with a movie in 2010.
Yeah, I watched
that.
Too
bad.
It wasn't bad. Then did you watch the sequel, Legends of Korra?
Mm-hmm.
That was good. That's on Amazon Prime if you have that.
I watched some of that. And but speaking on Chowder and stuff, that was my childhood.
Shout out to
right
Caleb's
there.
Mom.
You know, it was.
She is in the chat.
Was really
Caleb,
good
your
stuff.
Mom's here. Say hi.
Thank you so much for the banana pudding and the pie. We're gonna enjoy that. I'd just like to thank you so much, and we can't wait to enjoy some of that.
Yeah, Elijah is in love with
the banana pudding.
With the banana pudding.
You guys should have tried some.
I think it's time that we pull our other two guests up here, Caleb and Hunter. Let's go, guys. Come on. Yep, that thing. And then we're going to get some takes on them and how they're feeling about this whole thing. Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Hi.
How y'all doing? You're going to, just pull that. She's not really saying much anyways. Irrelevant.
She's
irrelevant. Just tell us if anything goes down in the chat.
People are just saying that they're happy for both of you guys.
I think everyone's happy for you guys.
Appreciate it.
So if you were in... first lunch, you got to see the music video released before noon, so consider yourself special. But you can see that a lot of work has gone into this. And so now that some people have seen it, you've seen the reaction, how are you guys feeling about the song?
I mean, we put a lot of time and effort into this. I mean, writing songs and singing and playing guitar, it's not an easy thing to do. And, putting all this together, editing it, and I know that's not easy either. I wouldn't even know where to start on that. I'm so thankful for all the help that I've gotten, and I'm thankful for Hunter being here with me, tagging along, and I'm just ready to progress and get better and, see what more songs we can come up with and release to the public, let you guys listen to them.
Yeah. This is just a start, too. Like, I know after today, I think we're starting on some new music. I think we're going to start on some new music. I mean, building, we got websites in the make. I mean, y'all are going big.
Yeah.
Now, you have to promise, if you go famous, I want credit.
Yeah, we got a YouTube, we got a Patreon, we got a SoundCloud, got my own personal website that they're making for me, and we're actually thinking about making some merchandise, like t-shirts and stuff.
Did I get a free one?
Yeah, I'll let you get a free one.
I just want a picture of your face, though. I don't want it to be anything just to your face. But... No, you guys, was today the first time you saw the music video all put together?
No, I saw it yesterday, actually.
Saw it yesterday?
Yeah.
What was your first thought when, you saw that? Hunter, did you see it yesterday, too?
No.
Today was the first time?
Yeah.
Okay, so give me your guys' initial reaction to seeing that.
Well, I mean, I thought it was really good. I mean, nothing that I've ever done before. And, being here and getting this together, I mean, it's very exciting. And I was really nervous when we released it to everybody. I'm just sitting there just shaking,
I think we got a good reaction today. I think we got a pretty good reaction.
Yeah. You got anything you want to say?
I mean, like he said, I wouldn't know where to start, and I thought it was amazing. So, especially for our first one. Too.
Yeah, I mean, it was. Yeah, this process took a good amount of time, just everyone getting used to, how we mixing music and, all that, and just how to record it. But, I mean, I'm excited to see what you guys are going to do in the future. Like,
yeah,
I
me
mean,
too.
The next song, better than the last? Or
it could be. I mean, I have three more songs that we can make music videos to, or, you know, just do audios. And I started writing another song last night, so I'm just going to keep doing it.
So we're going to have a whole iTunes playlist soon, aren't we?
I hope so, yeah. I want to get an album made, so that'd be good.
So do you listen to your own music? Like, when this is on iTunes, is this going to be, like, number one in your playlist? Or are you the type of person that doesn't like to listen to yourself?
I have to say yes and no to that. I mean, sometimes I like to pretend I'm, like, the other person listening to myself and kind of critiquing, you know, what I can do better and just, you know, think, well, those certain parts sound really good in that song and, like, how I could make it better. But sometimes I just hate listening to myself, you know, sing. It's just one of those things, and I don't know. I get kind
of. I'm the type of person who does. I don't like to watch. Like, once we get done filming and stuff, I don't like to watch it back.
Yeah.
I don't like watching myself. But
yeah.
Elijah, you got any questions for him?
No questions. All I can say is I enjoyed the music, and I think more people should listen to it. We should help them get their music out and getting more people listen to it.
Yes, for sure. Like, if you have Apple Music, Spotify, anything, just liking it or downloading it would mean a lot to them. And he said a second ago, I wanted to add on, Patreon.com. They have set up a Patreon where you can donate to Kaleb and Hunter monthly so they can keep pursuing their music career, and that would mean a lot to them, and just helping produce their music, because I think both of you want to do this in the future, right?
Yes, definitely.
And so, okay, we're going to play it right now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Wait, like right now?
Well, okay, well, I was just told we are... We're playing. Okay, so we're going. Thank you, guys.
You're welcome. And thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to be back in a second after we play the music video. But, yeah, thank you, guys, and let's do it.
Girl, you're my everything. wait.
That was so good.
Keep going. We're going to do one to you too. Ready? Let's go back.
That was so good, though.
It was so close.
It was so good.
Not ready for somebody.
Just looking at the camera, go, yeah, baby. Keep going.
That was so cute.
He started laughing. That's good.
The wind is blowing cold. Have we lost our way to not? Have we lost our hope to sorrow? Feels like we're all alone, running further from what's right, and there are no more heroes to follow.
You guys just saw the music video, and special thanks to Ms. Peterson's class for putting this all together. Remember, you can find the music video on YouTube, and then you can listen to it on SoundCloud, Spotify, and iTunes, I think. Anywhere else? I think those are the three we're going with.
Yeah, we're working on it. Okay, so YouTube and SoundCloud for sure right now.
Right now, those two will be for sure. And at Kaleb Kelsay. They're all Kaleb Kelsay, right?
Yeah, Kaleb Kelsay. Yeah.
Okay, any last words to say to anybody?
I just thank y'all for watching this. You know, we put a lot of, you know, time into this, and it was not easy. But just thank y'all for your support and for listening to our stuff. And we look forward to progressing and writing more songs for you to listen to, and I'll be on my YouTube channel.
Can we get a Grammy speech when you win a Grammy? What's our speech going to look like?
Well, I mean, I just want to thank my parents for their support. I mean, my dad, he taught me how to play guitar and to sing at a young age, and I want to thank him for that. And my stepdad, he's taught me a lot of things about singing and playing guitar as well. And my mom is just there for moral support, you know, supporting me along the way.
Yeah, no, I think we're going to have to work on that because I didn't tear up enough. We're going to give a Grammy speech. I'm going to need to tear up a little bit more. Hunter, you got anything to say?
I just want to thank everybody for the moral support that we've received for it. And it's been really fun, and I'm really looking forward to what will be next. So.
Okay, well, I think we're done here. Thank you, guys. And, yes, please, everybody go check out the video and the music. Listen to it. I mean, it's a good song. Add it to your playlist. I know you have worse songs in your playlist, so. But now we're done. We're out. Deuces.
Peace.
Thanks for watching.
Follow us on Twitter. Subscribe on YouTube.
And follow us on Instagram.
@LHFNewsMag.